Taylor Smith, aka The Career Coach, and I'm here today to talk to y'all about your resume, specifically what I call SMART descriptions. So in some of my other videos, I already mentioned this. So I originally recorded a video related to the resume and realized it was just so much freaking content. And it would be more digestible if I separated it into four videos for y'all. So hopefully you've already seen the first two. The first one is related to resume 101. So when you're first getting started with your resume or updating it, some things to kind of keep in mind. The second video is related to sections to include in your resume. So one by one, I talk about all the things that you can include, kind of your non-negotiables, but also some add-ons. So if you realize that you don't have a lot of experience and you need to add some more stuff, these are some additional things that you can add on your resume to make you sound great. This video is about SMART descriptions. So this is related to like your professional experience, your leadership experience, relevant projects, community service, really creating descriptions for these or bullet points that highlight what exactly you did and take you to another level to get noticed by recruiters. That's what we're talking about right now. And then the last video I have are just some final tips and tricks when you're finishing up your resume or you might be hitting some roadblocks, just some things to keep in mind to kind of help you keep moving. So all that being said, I do want to remind y'all that I am a career coach. So I help students and young professionals advance their careers and find that job. So the three main services I offer are related to resumes, elevator pitches, and interviewing. And what I really do is I work with my clients one-on-one with personalized coaching to help them focus on their accomplishments, the things that they have already achieved, and align them with the things that companies are looking for so that you get noticed, so that you get placed at the top of their candidate list, and so that you get those job offers. So if you want to get some one-on-one personalized coaching, go ahead and visit my website, taylorosmith.com, to book you an appointment. Or you can also email me or contact me on my socials. You can slide in my DMs if you have any questions prior to booking your appointment. But if you really want to get to that next level, go ahead and book a session with me. So with all of that being said, let's go ahead and talk about SMART descriptions. So what are SMART descriptions? Honestly, I kind of made this up, but I think that it works so well. So SMART is an acronym that's typically used for goal setting. So if you watched one of my other videos related to creating goals and executing them, I talk about the SMART method, which is an acronym that you can use. But I think that the SMART method is actually very applicable to adding experience to your resume as well. So we're going to talk about that in just a second and how it applies. But SMART is an acronym, like I mentioned, and it stands for specific, measurable, attainable, relevant, and time bound. And we're going to dive into each of those in right now. So specific, you really want to paint a picture to your recruiter, your interviewer, whoever is reading your resume, so they can really understand what it is that you accomplished on your resume, right? You want to be very clear to them, right? You want them to really be able to understand what it is that you did without you always having to provide additional information or data. So you want to make sure that you also avoid jargon, basically terminology that other people might not understand. You want to think of it as, can I explain this to a first grader or maybe a fourth grader? But if you can, then your resume is pretty clear, right? You don't want to assume that anybody knows exactly what you're talking about. You want to try to avoid acronyms like an SOP. You might not even know what that is. That is a standard operating procedure. And even though other people I work with in my current industry, they might know what that is, other people might not for other positions or companies I might be applying for. So make sure that you keep that in mind and you try to minimize that as much as possible or eliminate it altogether. All right. So the next part of your resume, which is SMART, which is probably the most important, is measurable. So this is basically your metrics. What number are you tying into each description to explain the magnitude of what it is that you accomplished? So I tell my clients that each of your descriptions should have at least one measurable or metric within that description to really give an idea or a sense of what you achieved. So for an example, let's say that I am like a chapter president, right? And one of my bullets is that I led an executive team, or I led my members with weekly meetings or whatever. But if I were to tell you that I worked with an executive board of 30 people and over 300 members, that sounds impressive and amazing versus what I just told you before, when you have no idea how many I worked with. I could have worked with an executive board of 5 people, or it could be 30 people. So by putting some numbers and context in there, that really gives the reader a better idea of what you did. And don't be ashamed if it was 5 people on your executive board. That's still something good. So list those things on your resume to give people an idea. Or maybe I'm a cashier, right? I manage money every day. I work with customers. Specify how much money in that register are you counting every day, you know? Because you're counting it up at the end of the shift. You can tell them an estimate. You know, I manage $5,000 to $10,000 within my cash register, or I greet and assist 30 customers a day. So add those extra details in there, because it really makes you sound impressive. If you save them money, the company any money, if you've done any time reductions, you might have to get a little bit creative and think about it, but add those things into your resume. They're only going to help you. All right, so the next portion is to be attainable. So what I mean by this is really being honest about what you put on your resume. Was what you actually achieved feasible, right? So I mentioned this a little bit before. Did you save the company money? Did you save the company time by reducing any delays, a time reduction? So you want to make sure that you're honest about this, right? I don't want to say that I saved the company millions or thousands and billions of dollars, when in actuality, I only saved a little bit. And you should still be proud of your accomplishment, right? So one of my internships, I was a buyer and I saved the company $800. And at first I was really shy and nervous to add that on there, because people were saving millions and thousands and billions of dollars, like I mentioned. And $800 just seemed so small. But in actuality, it was pretty good, right? I was buying bolts and screws for the company that cost about $3 to $5 each. I was also only there for 4 months. And what else? I captured 20% deflation. So 20% deflation is a target that a lot of people strive for, and it's actually pretty good. I should go ahead and list that, because all the other context, all the other details are specifics that I put into my resume. Really hope that recruiter understand, oh, she did a good job. $800, that was great for the magnitude of things that she was buying, right? Make sure that you are honest. If I would have said that I saved like thousands of dollars, they could easily go back and they could talk to that person that I did an internship with, a reference, right? And they can validate that, because it may seem a little fishy. It may not seem very feasible. So make sure that you are honest about the things that you put on your resume. And don't be ashamed. Be proud of what you did. What else? Yeah, make sure you're realistic and also have some ownership. So oftentimes I see people talk about what they did as a team. So I worked on a team and we accomplished this, or we did this and we did that. You want your resume to be I. What did you achieve? What did you bring to the table? You know, this is your one time to really be confident and a little bit cocky about what you did. Of course you want to be humble, but we're talking about you. And I used to be a person that I didn't want to take the credit when it was a group effort, right? Especially if it was older people I'm working with, and they did all the work. But this is your one time to take credit for that. You know, don't be so modest. You did a lot and you should take credit for that. So keep those things in mind when you're adding stuff to your resume. So the next thing I want to talk about is relevancy. You want to make sure that your resume stays relevant. So you talk about the things that directly impact the position you worked in, or, you know, that industry, whatever. And you want to make sure that you remain relevant. You're not really talking about random stuff. You want to make sure you have the most relevant stuff on your resume related to the position you're applying for. But if you don't have a lot of experience, that's okay to have other things on your resume too. Sometimes they make you stand out, right? They're still great leadership skills. So maybe during one of your internships, you only really worked on one project and you can only squeeze maybe two bullets about that project. But you need to add like maybe a third bullet or a fourth one. If you did any stuff with the interns, maybe you planned some events, right? Or maybe you did some trainings and some learnings to really help with your professional development. Go ahead and list those. I completed 20 trainings, or I shadowed 3 people, or I led 2 intern events with 30 attendees. So these are things that you can include in your resume to really make you stand out and take you to that next level. They can still be considered relevant because it's still related to the encompassment of your job. But do keep in mind, you want to remain relevant, especially if you're running out of space on your resume. And then lastly, you want to make sure that you specify the time period, so time bound. If I was in a position for May 2020, I want to make sure that I specify that I was there from, if I was in a role for summer 2020, I don't want to just say summer 2020. I want to be specific in the months, the duration. So I was there from May 2020 to August 2020. So follow the month year format. Again, avoid just saying summer 2020. That is a blanket statement. I don't know if that's 1 week, if that's 1 month, 2 years, like obviously summer 2020 isn't 2 years, but make sure that you guys are very clear on that when you add that stuff to your resume. So I can give a couple examples really quickly. So when I was a summer intern, one of the bullets I had was that I worked on a team and updated 60% of customer accounts with clear delivery instructions. That was my before. That sounds pretty solid. You know, I told you I updated customer accounts, did 60% of them. That's pretty good, right? But I went ahead and updated it after some mentoring and coaching from some people, and I improved it to updated 150 customer accounts for 35 sales representatives to improve delivery services. So that gives you some more context. 60% of what? That could literally be 2 out of 3. I have no clue, but I completed 150 of them. That's pretty impressive. So that sounds really great to hear. And not only that, I worked with 35 sales representatives. So that alludes to the reader that I know how to manage people, that I know how to work collaboratively, right? With 35 different sales representatives who are very, very busy people. So that's kind of incorporating some of those soft skills. You know, I know how to manage teams, or I know how to work collaboratively. So that's a way that you can sneak those things in there. So that's one example. And another example I want to give is when I was a sales associate at Abercrombie. So this was kind of hard for me to add this on my resume at first because I was undermining what I did. I was like, all I really did was like fold clothes, I talked to customers, etc. But these are 2 bullet points I had before. So I had maintained store appearance and upkeep, and I also managed the cash register for customer purchases. So those are my 2 bullet points. I think that explains pretty well what I did, right? You get an idea. That is what I accomplished. But I took it to a whole nother level again with some mentoring and coaching. And I updated it to average 2 online sales per day to provide alternate solutions for items unavailable in store. I totally forgot that we pushed online sales, and the average we wanted to aim for was 2 a day. And that tells me that I had a customer focused mind. I didn't just turn customers away when we didn't have products. Instead, I provided alternate solutions. We have stuff online, or here's something that's the same color, but a different slightly style that you might like. So providing those to our customers so they don't leave empty handed until we get sales. That's important, y'all. What else? I greeted and assisted approximately 30 customers per day with purchases and special requests. So I'm telling you how many customers I help per day. I could even take it to another level because I may have worked with double or triple that amount when it was tax-free day during the summer, or when it was the holidays during Christmas and Black Friday. So definitely include those so people understand the magnitude of the work you did. And lastly, I had standardized 500 plus items daily by size and color to allow easy accessibility for customers. So this is back to folding clothes. I easily folded 500 items a day, especially if I was closing, folding or reorganizing it when it's all over the store and putting it back where it belongs. Standardization is really important, not just within the retail world, but within the workforce too, corporate America. So these are things that you can kind of keep in mind to take your resume to the next level. Sometimes we don't know what we don't know. If you've never worked in corporate America, you don't really know what those guys are looking for. So that's why it's important to get a career coach, to find a mentor, someone who can really help you take your resume to that next level and align to the things that companies are looking for. So that's all I have for this video today. I hope you guys learned something new about smart descriptions and you can update your resumes and take them to the next level. Again, if you do want to get that personalized one-on-one coaching to help personally take you to the next level, I highly suggest investing in a career coach because it's going to take you far. If you do get like an engineering internship or a STEM internship, you will literally have paid me back within your first 2 hours of working because of the amount of money that you'll be making. So the investment is definitely worth it, you guys. 100%. Hope you guys learned something. Stay tuned for my other videos related to the resume to kind of take you to the next level. I'm also going to have more videos related to elevator pitches and interviewing within the coming weeks, so stay tuned. And I will see you guys next time. Thank y'all so much. Make sure to like and subscribe on YouTube and to follow me on my socials. All right, see y'all later. Bye.